Welcome back. I hope you're all well. So in today's video, I wanted to talk about the five best street style luxury bags. Now, when I say street style, I'm not talking about designer bags that are very popular and very like sought after, very like trendy. I'm more so talking about bags that are understated, but yet that are really cool and edgy and really make you stand out and that I see a lot of people wear on the streets. Oh my God, that sounds so weird. But anyways, I feel like it was really important for me to make a video like this because I do this a lot. I always talk about bags that are popular and that are very trendy and that are very fashionable at the moment. But the older I get, and I'm not even really that old, but when I was 22, like I cared all about buying the next it bag and buying the most popular bag and buying a bag that everybody else had as well. But now that I'm 29, I'm like, you know what? I would much rather have a bag that totally fits me and my style, that's cool and edgy, or you know, cool and classic, whatever I'm going for, but that not everyone has, but it's still gonna make me stand out and it's gonna be unique. And that's what I feel like street style bags are, like even street style fashion. I just love seeing people style outfits, bags, shoes differently, and you know, make it kind of their own, make it unique and express themselves. So yeah, I wanted to talk about these bags because I feel like they don't get enough love. So if you're someone that wants to buy a bag that, you know, not everyone has and that's not like super in your face, trendy right now, then I think these are all really good bags to go with. Some of them are vintage, so you have to do a little bit of research. But if that's not your style, but you just wanna know what people on the streets are wearing, then also keep on watching. And I'm gonna stop rambling because the longer I ramble on in my intros, the less I make sense. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Okay, starting off with number one, which are Chanel vintage shoulder bags. Now, these bags, in my opinion, are so cool, so unique. And I personally am currently looking at maybe purchasing a vintage Chanel shoulder bag because number one, like I mentioned at the beginning, when you get something vintage or something that everyone else has, obviously it's gonna stand out, it's gonna be a little more unique, you're gonna get a lot more questions on it versus going maybe to the store and buying like a brand new Chanel bag or whatever off the shelf. So I really am loving the different people that I see styling these. New York City, there's a lot of people that run around with these bags. LA, I mean, I was in New York earlier this year and I saw these types of bags a lot. And every time I saw someone with that bag, I was like, oh my God, like I love it. I have to have one of these, just so cool. It's such a vibe. And again, it kind of stands out. It's different and not everyone is gonna have it, and you can just style it so many different ways. Actually, most of the bags that I'm going to be talking about today are in fact vintage bags. So number two are Fendi Zucca print bags. And yes, I know these were more popular a while ago and they're still kind of popular now, but not as bad as some other bags that are aggressively being shoved down our throats. You all know I'm not a fan of that. But I did actually buy myself a Christmas gift this year. I bought myself a Fendi bag and I'm gonna probably show it to you guys after Christmas or something like that. But I absolutely love it. It's so cute. And this is another bag that I see lots and lots of people wearing that are kind of understated, people that are not like, not like huge social media influencers, but maybe influencers that are smaller, that have like a very like unique style, that don't wear necessarily what everybody else is wearing. And again, I love how these bags are being styled. You can get them for a really affordable price, starting anywhere from $400 and up. Obviously, you can also buy a brand new Fendi bag with the Zucca print, but for a bag like this, and if you want it to be kind of edgy and cool, I would definitely go for a vintage. Next up, a bag that I'm seeing a lot, not on social media, but even in the area that I live in, are Gucci satchel bags. Now, these are, in my opinion, again, very cool. Now, obviously, if these aren't your style, then you might not like them as much, but I recently actually saw a girl, which inspired me to do this video, wear one of these when I was at the mall, and I was like, it was an outside mall, by the way, but when I was at the mall, and I was like, you know what, that looks so freaking cool. Again, it's not your typical, like, Pochette Matisse or Prada re-edition or, you know, Gucci Marmont. It's just a bag that you don't see a lot of people wear, and the way she had it styled, it looked super, super cool. And I have been seeing satchel bags Gucci ones a lot more, also on the pre-love market and stuff like that. So again, you can get these for a really good price, and I love them, and they're so easy to style. Next up, this is probably one of my favorite bags out of this entire video, and that's the YSL. I think it's called the Kaya shoulder bag. First of all, again, this is a little bit personal preference and what your style is, but I think a lot of you have similar style to mine. I think this is a very, very classic yet cool laid back bag. We do have the logo on there, which I know a lot of people don't always like flashing the logo. I personally don't mind. I like a little logo moment on my bags, but I think this is a really cool bag, very understated, definitely something that you don't see all over social media, but that you do see people in real life wearing a lot. Very cool bag. This is another one that I first discovered when I was in New York earlier this year, and I also remember seeing it and I was like, oh my god, I love it. Do I have to have it? Maybe. To be honest with you guys, like, I love YSL. Like, I have a couple more bags now on my wish list, and like, a lot of them are YSL. Like, I love YSL. I do wish that the resale value was a little better, but like, I love them. I love the style. I love the aesthetic. They're just, I don't know, they're very gorgeous to me. They're very much me. They fit my wardrobe. But yeah, loving this bag. I think it's super cool. If you want to get something that is not something everyone has, that is understated, but that's gonna get you a lot of compliments and that people are gonna like look at, I would definitely get this. It is so, so pretty. And last but not least is the Celine small Boston bag. Now, this bag isn't necessarily my style, but if you are someone that loves the Louis Speedies, then I think you would really like this bag. Now, to me, this is a little more in your face. This is a little more, I don't know, a little more fashion forward. It's not as much of a safe choice. I do think it's quite cheaper than the Speedy, but I really like this. It does look really cool, and like I said, this is just street style stuff. This is stuff that I feel like people, real life people, wear, and I think it's a cool bag, and if it's your style, I think it can definitely be styled in a very cool way. And again, if you love the Speedy, like, it just kind of reminds me a little bit of the Speedy. Let me know if you guys feel the same, or if that's just me, I don't know. But yeah, so many different ways that you can style this and just make it look very unique and just bring your personal style forward, if you know what I mean. So yeah, that is it for today's video. I really hope that you guys liked it. Like I said at the beginning, if you did, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.